is our test force, many of them standing and sitting right behind me. It is so awesome to have the team responsible for making the best networks even better join us for today's episode. Now, the test force engineers joining us today are part of roughly 3,000 engineers across the country working in network assurance and system performance functions. They are dedicated to providing a reliable, high-quality experience for customers, rain or shine. And at the end of the day, when it comes to our network, we don't compromise on reliability. In fact, today we're celebrating Network Reliability Day to acknowledge our relentless pursuit of network excellence. And joining me to explain what this looks like for Verizon is Julie Slattery, Senior Vice President of Core Engineering and Operations. Julie, so great to have you on Up to Speed.
Thanks for having me.
So, Julie, obviously, Test Force is a big part of our network reliability here at Verizon.
Absolutely.
But what else does that look like here?
Yeah, I mean, Test Force is a huge piece of that. Our engineers are the best in the industry, and
yes,
they make all of the difference. But network reliability is everything. It's our brand. We are the network that America relies on, right? And it is the single most important thing that we can offer to our customers. And that's why we designated today, October 4th, as Network Reliability Day. Now, we know, we in the network team, we think about reliability literally 24 hours a day, 365 yep, days a year. It is embedded into every single thing that we do. It is how we design and engineer and run and operate our network. But today is an opportunity to reflect across the business on how every single one of us impacts network reliability. Whether you are like these men and women out here on the front line engineering and building the network, whether you are working with customers to resolve issues, yeah, or part of the broader V team that can offer your feedback on your experience via the My Verizon app, we all have a role to play.
That's awesome. Now, speaking of that, and you mentioned that it's embedded in our culture here, what are some of the ways that we see that ingrained within the culture at Verizon?
Sure. So for our frontline teams, we have a mantra, prepare, pause, confirm.
I like it.
Prepare, complete all of your pre-checks. Ensure that all of the necessary work is performed in maintenance windows. Make sure that you review your methods of procedure prior to beginning your work. For pause, if the instructions are vague, you have a lack of clarity on what you were supposed to do, make sure that you pause and ask questions. And finally, confirm. Make sure your work was done properly, complete your post-checks and testing. So prepare, pause, confirm. For customer-facing employees, we were deliberate in putting Network Reliability Day in the middle of Customer Service Week. And that's because it is so important to our customers' experience. So make sure you're listening to your customers, understanding issues, and reporting them appropriately so that we can resolve and address.
That's awesome. All very important information to consider and remember. Now, Julie, we talked many times on Up to Speed about the network feedback tool. You can find it in the My Verizon app. We all have a role to play, and that's a good way to report any outages, any issues that we're having.
Yes.
Any update on that?
Yes. So the feedback tool is going very well. We have received thousands of inputs from employees across the business.
Wow.
We utilize that information in a crowdsourcing tool for analytics, and we feed it to the teams that are making decisions about how we build our network. We also launched a trial. We're in pilot mode right now on making that tool available externally for our customers. So we're super excited about the opportunity of where we can take that. And we will definitely come back on another episode to give an update.
All right, I'm looking forward to it. Thank you, Julie.
Thank you.
Really appreciate you coming on to talk about network reliability. So important. Thank you. Now, team, reliability is something that is always top of mind. And recently, we've seen how we've shined at Mobile World Congress, the new Sphere in Las Vegas. Pretty cool if you haven't seen it. And even NFL stadiums like the home of the Denver Broncos at Empower Stadium. So, to close this out, let's take a look at how our engineers are getting us ready for game time.
Hey, we're at Empower Field, and the fans are in for a big treat this season. Since last season, we've installed over 50 millimeter wave nodes, and we have over 900 antennas. So whether they're tailgating in the parking lot or sitting in the seats and want to share the action, we've got them covered.
So we're in Denver, Colorado at Empower Field. What I'm super excited about in the stadium today is our 51 millimeter wave 5G nodes that can provide up to 4 gigabits per second of downlink throughput speeds, which allows people to do whatever they want, whenever they want. Stadium environments provide a special challenge to the network just by the sheer number of people. And so we have to put a lot of antennas. We have nearly 1,000 antennas in this stadium. So no matter where you're standing or sitting, you're never too far from an antenna that's gonna give you an amazing experience. The antenna that covers that, like I said, it's not that ugly antenna from another carrier. Ours is actually on the side of this building behind this tree. Under the seat, you can see an orange box.
Oh,
that's gonna be part of the DAS system. We have an incredible local team that watches this network while it's under load, while there's a game. We have people monitoring the system. Between games, we're making sure that everything is running smoothly and is ready for the next game. We've got 51 nodes. A lot of those are new for millimeter wave. We want to see how those respond to people. We've got engineers watching it right now. We've been working with the Broncos for over a decade. We have a strong relationship with them. They have a mutual desire to provide the best experience for their fans. And so they want us to be here to provide that experience, and they help us to put that system in place. People sometimes ask, why do you need 4 gigabits per second, which is what we can provide here with millimeter wave 5G. You know what? Ask me in 2 years and I'll tell you. So we are ahead of where the users, where our customers are today. We're ready for what they're gonna bring to us tomorrow.
From Empower Field, we're ready for kickoff. And until next time, you're up to speed.